I don't care if it was 50, it was 30, 40 inches of snow tonight. Everybody who sits underneath your ministry on any given Sunday or any given night, because you're here all the time, should have made their way out here. I don't care if they had to crawl in the snow. Because we don't get this part here. He preaches. He teaches to unadulterate the word of God. Everywhere he goes, he beautifies the temple. Why does he have to make provision for himself?
Yes. Come on here. Hey now.
You got to say that to the Lord. Listen, I know I'm in the house because God sent me to the house with this word. I know I'm here. So you don't have to say amen. You don't have to wave your hand. You can just sit there with a straight face. I know I'm talking to you. Listen to me carefully here. Listen, that should be you should be making provision for him. He shouldn't have to put together a financial team.
Come on here.
You said you know his heart.
Come on here.
If you know his heart, why haven't you established a team?
Come on here.
Why haven't you spoke to his needs?
Come on.
Come on here, son.
Come on here.
Oh, you don't want to talk to me here. God. I got a few more minutes. I ain't going to beat you up with this. I just got to give it to you. He's ministered holy things.
Yes.
And the things that he's ministered is keeping you alive.
Yes. My God.
The things that he's ministered is giving you hope.
Uh-huh.
The things that he's ministered is inspiring you over and over again. Come on here, somebody talk to me here.
Yes.
Sometimes you come to church, you don't want to be here. But after you get here, you're inspired. Come on here.
Yes.
You don't want to talk to me. Sometimes you get here, it's time for you to go forth in your ministry. You don't want to sing. But when you get up, the apostle said, go ahead, go and sing. Say, see what he's doing? He's pushing you with the anointing. And then you feel the impact of his push, and you feel like you want to sing now. Like baby girl right here. When she got up, she really didn't want to get in there, but then when she stepped in there and he said, go ahead, daughter, sing, she didn't lift her voice and sound like the trumpet in time because of push.
Yeah.
Get your name and tell us by way of the anointing. I want to talk to you here now. So now you got to figure out a way. How can I better serve my manservant?
Uh-huh.
Or how can I better serve him in the first lady? I need to better position myself. I need to make some financial adjustments so that I can have substance to invest. God, help me here. I need to make some adjustments because I need them to know that I understand their heart, and I know they need to get away sometime. I don't need them going away just once a month. It got to be strenuous, as hard as he preaches, as hard as he teaches. He's in the church all the time. Certainly, I know he needs a vacation. He save up a lot of coins. I'm gonna go on Google and I'm gonna get him, find him something. It's on me. And I'm gonna tell the apostle, you go and do what you got to do. You're the first lady, get yourself together. Now, who you wanna leave here to preach is, listen, we'll serve them just like we serve you, but we're gonna let them know this is our daddy house.
That's
right. See, when you know how to establish yourself and undergird him, that's certain stuff you just don't take. I don't care who walks up in here, you let it know, you're just a visitor.
Yes.
Can I preach up in here? You're just a visitor, and you've been given a privilege. But don't walk up and act like you're trying to take over, because I'm about to serve notice on you. That's another reason he don't go a lot of time. Who gonna cover the house? Y'all, I lost the church when y'all. Who gonna cover the house? I know Mr. Sherrell. I know he's there. I know he loved me, but that's a lot of other things that he got to have in his spirit so that he can kind of understand and discern the things that goes on in the atmosphere like that. I know Brother Malik, I know he loved me. I know my daughters love me, but I can't lead them to the wolves. That's the dedication that he made. Listen, by way of the anointing. Yeah. And you can't even see that far, which means you're not spiritual as you thought.
Come on.
Oh, my God. Oh, God. I feel this here. So, Minister Shamel, you're going to have to reestablish your financial team, and you're going to have to say to them, we doing okay, but we can do better. Uh-huh. Yeah. Come on, here. And then you lead out. Come on here. You lead out by example. If you step up underneath the anointing, I guarantee you the rest of the team will follow. The challenge when you want to bump shoulder, rub shoulders with the man of God. It's a price to pay to get too close.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it's a price to pay. Lord Jesus. He shouldn't have to worry about if he go on vacation, who's going to have the house. It's more than just preaching, see.
Yes, sir. Way more than that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, who gonna cover my daughters? Who gonna cover my seniors?
Yes.
Who gonna cover my children? Hasn't anyone stepped up to the plate and showed him in the spirit that they can handle the responsibility? See, and this it's not always being up in his face, it's about being in position. I don't know what's in you until you're humble yourself. Listen, I know what you're capable of doing, but until you get in the right position, even I can't see your heart.
Jesus.
Right now. Mm-hmm. Let's look at the neighbor, say, live and let live. Come on, look at the neighbor, tell him it's not all about you.